Hey, hey, you're with TheEZGZ. I got a little story I want to share with you today. When you're down here by the sand dunes, a lot of times to pass the time, you are looking at old magazines and things. Here's an old sand sorts magazine from spring of 1996. And there was a sand car in here I thought was pretty interesting. I remember seeing this because I think I have this magazine at home. And it says, there's a little mid-engine sand car, custom, called PLUM Crazy. Nice looking car, really state-of-the-art for 1996. Feature car in the Sand Sports magazine. And they're out there on the sand dunes. And the interesting side note, or backstory on this thing, is that Darren has made some big plans for the use of his buggy at the end of March this year. You see, Darren and Michelle will be reciting wedding vows on the sand in the California desert, and he plans on using his buggy as transportation. So you can understand why we would say the next time you hear someone say Darren Rogers loves the dunes, you'd have to be plumb crazy not to believe it. I wonder if Darren Rogers is still married to that lady 21 years later. I hope he sees this video and he has good memories with the car and his wife, and they're still the other. But here it is today, that same darn car. It was on Craigslist. My buddy Doug bought it, and the guy delivered it this morning. We've been checking it out here, and I asked him if I could make a video of it. It's had a few changes over the years. It had a 1915 in it, and that has been upgraded to a 2332 with a turbocharger on it. That's right. I just drove it a couple hours ago after the guy delivered it. It's got Coney shocks on the back, and these actually move. They actually go up and down. Ugh. They do. I was just out on for a ride. The front end was a little stiff, and we're swapping out the front shocks for it. They had KYB gas adjust shocks. That's way too stiff when you got nothing on the front like this. You want wore out stock shocks is what you want. And a little tip, you can put them on upside down, and that'll make them even work easier. You want a little bit of dampening for a sudden impact, but you don't need a lot of shock. It is no long travel car, and the fellow that sold it says that's kind of one of the reasons why he was selling it. All of his high dollar buddies were getting long travel cars, and he just decided, rather than try to keep up with the Joneses, that he'd stop going completely. So we got the car because it's just our speed and just our style, and I'm so jealous that he's got this turbo on this thing. So maybe tomorrow when it's all cooled down good, we'll pop the valve covers and do a valve check. The guy we bought it from was very honest and upfront, and he told us that he was no mechanic, and that he'd taken it to the dunes, had no problems with it, and didn't do any mechanical work himself. The transmission was recently worked on by somebody other than TheEZGZ. I haven't had too good of luck lately. I don't know why, what's going on, but you know, maybe it's parts, maybe it's me, I don't know, maybe it's a little bit of both. But at any rate, that's one thing that we don't have to worry about. It stays in gear, shifts nice, feels like it's a close ratio box for sure. Doug was telling me there was a tag on it someplace. I don't see it, but maybe it gives the date of the rebuild or some kind of information. It's got heavy duty side covers on both sides, but looks like a cool buggy, and it's mid-engine, rides entirely different than the tail draggers engine hanging off the back. But I told the, it's got nice CNC disc brakes, and we put these car tires on it just to take it over to this vacant lot down the street and run around in it a little bit to see how it felt. It's got a remote oil cooler under the gas tank. I thought that was an unusual place to put it, but when a car is 21 years old and it's got this much wear on it, they must have done something right. So yeah, really like it, and I wanted to share it with you guys. I thought that you would enjoy taking a look at it. And we've been looking it over and discovering things, and I'm glad you could come along. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subbing. Easy Jeezy out.